We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Vampirella The Dark Powers, Issue 1 from Dynamite from 2020, written by Dan Abnett, art by Paul Davidson, colors by Andrew Dalhouse, letters by Hassan Otsmane-Elhaou, main cover by Jae Lee and June Chung. So the cover's okay, the proportions all look weird, and why does one of her hips look really big? Why does her face look like a doll? Yeah, I don't like it. Boring, doesn't tell you anything about the issue, and everybody looks a little weird except for the lady. And yellow looks okay. So there's a team of people known as Anti-Clan. They're some sort of subversive terror group, and they are going after the banking system of the U.S. And Vampirella charges in and mows them down. Well, she wasn't supposed to be doing that, and she looks really hideous while she does it. Like, her face looks weird. She's supposed to be on a team with people called the Project, who are science heroes of sorts, including Fighting Yank, Liberator, the Woman in Red, Rocket Girl, and Black Terror. Mostly public domain characters. And those characters come off as pretty normal superhero fare, but Vampirella is not a team player. She's incredibly rude through the entire thing. She has this kind of downer mopiness to her that's really, really obnoxious. It's like Dan Abnett was watching repeats of Daria and wanted to make that character into a vampire. Because she didn't listen to the briefing, or she didn't understand it, I think she just wasn't listening and didn't care, she makes a hideous mistake, and it looks like it's gonna get a lot of people killed. So because of her rash arrogance, she didn't seem to grasp the concept that these were evolving biotech. So she's basically made these soldiers that she butchered evolve into a feral monster that's like a giant monster that is just set on rampaging. So out of her hubris, arrogance, disdain for the other team members, and the safety of the general public, a bunch of people are gonna get killed. This was a team book with a real jerk as the lead. I thought she was very unlikable in this. There's nothing really redeeming about her in this, except that she seems to have some minor guilt. But even then, I really didn't get the sense that she's going to try and work with anyone. This is a terrible team book. The other five members are actually acting like a team and trying to work together, despite the fact that they're from different worlds, even different times, and she is just unwilling to even try. It's very unlikable and pretty pathetic, so I'm not gonna recommend this. Thought the art was overall okay, except Vampirella looks physically ugly in a lot of scenes. Like, she actually looks repulsive at times. Otherwise, Black Terror looked good. Fighting Yank looked okay. Liberator looked pretty good. There were a few panels that I thought were a little lazy looking, but overall, pretty solid art. Just that she looks as ugly as she sounds. I'm not gonna recommend it because it's not a hero book. It's packaged like a superhero book, but she comes off as being a really chaotic, neutral version of Wolverine. She just wants to go in and kill a bunch of stuff. She won't listen to other people, she won't take advice, and she won't work and coordinate with others. Yeah, she's not a team player, but she doesn't even try, so why bother? If she's not going to put the effort in, then it's not a team book, it's just her going rogue. I find that kind of boring, so I'm not going to recommend this. I'm really disappointed. I was looking forward to it when I saw Dan Abnett was writing it, but this just comes off as another Mary Sue character that has complete disdain for everything around her, and that's really boring to me. So I'm not going to pick up issue 2, I don't think, unless I've already ordered it, so I have no interest in reading beyond this issue. That'll do it for this one. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description, and as always, we hope to see you on the next one.